بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه، أما بعد. Continuing إن شاء الله. For just revisiting the outline, we are so far in the part 3 analysis of topics of selected surah. We have, alhamdulillah, did Surah Al-Qiyamah and Surah Al-Takwir. Surah Al-Qiyamah and Surah Al-Takwir. In this analysis, we have used some of the principle of Tadabbur and reminding you the methodology, or maybe we'll come back to it when we get to the part number 4. The principle that we were using in the analysis of the topics was this one. The surah have an overall main topic, like a tree having different element but one root, one core. So that's the idea that we were referring to into the analysis of the two surah that we have mentioned. Also, the environment in which the surah was revealed, that will help us into the tahlili surah. That's mainly the one that we have mentioned, and actually also the connection of the ayat of the Quran. We gave example of that, but mainly is the number 2. Mainly is the number 2 that we have, using to explore the topics of the surahs. The Quran here we have in Surah. Okay, we started, I think, Surah Madani. Said let's have a Madani surah, which is Surah As-Saff. Surah As-Saff. Let's have Surah As-Saff in the English part. And I'll invite you to read Surah As-Saff and just to reflect on its topic. The main topic that the heart of the surah, helping us to find the main subject or the main message into the surah. It's لا إله إلا الله. طيب هي سبح لله ما في السماوات وما في الأرض وهو العزيز الحكيم. سبح لله ما في السماوات وما في الأرض وهو العزيز الحكيم. This ayah, subhanAllah, is an introduction to many of ayat in surah, like Al-Hadid without Ma, the second, Surah Al-Jumu'ah, and Surah Al-Taghabun, and Surah Al-Saf. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala قال يا أيها الذين آمنوا لم تقولون ما لا تفعلون كبر مقتا عند الله أن تقولوا ما لا تفعلون. We already touched on this ayah to summarize, and then we move on to another surah, and then inshallah ta'ala we're trying to do بإذن الله تعالى the tafsir starting today with surah al-Fatiha inshallah. And I will give you homework for next week. I will not be here, and that, as I said in the beginning of the class, and this homework will be inshallah to find a topic, the main topic for one surah, and then also the tafsir tahlili of it, that will I will ask you a question for it. It's good. طيب يا أيها الذين آمنوا لما تقولون ما لا تفعلون. لما تقولون, oh you who believe, why do you say that which you do not do. كبر مقتا عند الله أن تقولوا ما لا تفعلون. Most hateful it is with Allah that you say that which you do not do. إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ الَّذِينَ يُقَاتِلُونَ فِي سَبِيلِ صَفًّا كَأَنَّهُمْ بُنْيَانٌ مَرْصُوصٌ. Now, remember we said the topic, the name of the surah has a very strong relation with the main topic. So if we say the topic is as-saf, so the core, the root, the base is as-saf. What is as-saf? As-saf is the rows, the row. طيب. Let's, you know, do this analysis together. طيب. The tasbih, let's put it on the side because this is a very exhaustive, comprehensive ayah. In hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, in this ayah, Allah revealed to me almost, you know, everything. Because if you see everything in the heaven and the earth, they do worship and praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is enough for you to know everything in this universe, subhanAllah, that is servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. However, as an introduction, it has an impact on the reader. Then, يَا أَيُّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا لِمَ تَقُولُونَ مَا لَا تَفْعَلُونَ. What the question that we can ask here? O you who believe, why do you say that which you do not do? According to the analysis that we have done, okay? According to the methodology that we've been studying. If there's anything that we need to ask ourselves to help us find the topic. I mean, why we're talking about the topic is to help us also direct our vision in the interpretation of the surah. What do we need here? Something that we've been talking about last week. Sababun Nuzul. If there's any event that is related to it. So in the methodology, I mean the first thing after setting our vision, which is the vision of the Quran, starting with our aqidah, then the next point is to ask if there's any event related to this surah. Because all you believe, why do you say that which you do not do? I mean, if you read it, you're going to accuse yourself because this is directed to you. Said, if something happened in the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to say such a thing, let me check. So that's the first thing. You see how step by step we get to our understanding. So here in the hadith, that if you remember, of At-Tirmidhi mentioned in the Ibn Kathir. And by the way, the whole Tafsir Ibn Kathir is uploaded on the class. So I believe Brother Ibrahim send it. If not, he will send it again, the access code to the documents, inshallah ta'ala. فهنا يقول that there's people, they used to say, we wish there is, you know, a battle will go to fight and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will see how we are doing. And people, they say, you know, after, for example, an expedition happened, we said we did this and we did this and they didn't do it. So this ayah mostly is addressed to the munafiqeen. I can check in the book that you already have in English of Ibn Kathir, and he's saying here, قال, he talking about النفاق. قال, for example, here, just to see how we compile things, and this is what in the first, the beginning we said, to compile the ma'thur, to compile the ma'thur, what has been said in the books of tafsir by, you know, the predecessors, Salaf, to give us that vision, to give us that base of the understanding. So here, قال, آيَةُ المنافقي ثلاث, آيَةُ المنافقي ثلاث. The sign of the hypocrite are three: إذا وعد أخلف وإذا حدث كذب وإذا تمن خان. إذا وعد أخلف, when he promises he breaks his promise, and when he speaks he lies, and when he's entrusted he betrays the trust. From this alama, Allah Subhanahu wa Taala is talking by one of them. Why do you say that which you do not do? Okay. فهنا قال وقد روى الإمام أحمد وأبو داود عن عبد الله بن عامر ابن ربيعة قال أتانا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم وأنا صبي فذهبت لأخرج لألعب فقالت أمي يا عبد الله تعالى أعطيك فقال لا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم وما أردت أن تعطيه قالت تمرا so, أما إنك لو لم تفعلي كتبت كتبت عليك كذبة. Now, Ibn Kathir is giving us like the perspective of the general etiquette and behavior. So, the Sahabi, he said, the Prophet visited us and I was, you know, a child. I was going to play and his mother said, come back here, I'm going to give you something. So, the Prophet, he said, what are you going to give him? He said, date. He said, if you had said it without intending it, just to bring him back, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would have, you know, is being, will be recorded into your record as a lie. So see how the treatment, you know, to of the way of the education of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to teach us the way of acting. Tala. Then qala وحملوا الآية على أنها نزلت حين تمنوا فريضة الجهاد عليهم فلما فرض قال نكل عنهم بعضهم كقوله تعالى. When some of them they were wishing, you know, for the jihad to come, for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give them the permission for the jihad, when the jihad, which is, you know, here in this meaning to join battle in the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when it was revealed to them, they get scared and they rejected it. So why are you saying something that you really not intend to do? As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah An-Nisa, أَلَمْ تَرَ إِلَى الَّذِينَ قِيلَ لَهُمْ كُفُّوا أَيْدِيَكُمْ وَأَقِيمُوا الصَّلَاةَ وَآتُوا الزَّكَاةَ فَلَمَّا كُتِبَ عَلَيْهِمُ الْقِتَالُ إِذَا فَرِيقٌ مِّنْهُمْ يَخْشَوْنَ النَّاسَ كَخَشْيَةِ اللَّهِ أَوْ أَشَدَّ خَشْيَةً وَقَالُوا رَبَّنَا لِمَ كَتَبْتَ عَلَيْنَا الْقِتَالَ لَوْلَا أَخَّرْتَنَا إِلَى أَجَلٍ قَرِيبٍ. When the fight was prescribed on them, a group of them, they feared people more than they fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they said, Ya Allah, why you are, you know, making this an obligation? I mean, we could have, or like, لولا, it's like we wish that it's been delayed more, you know. However, all what has been said, the hadith that really that Ahlul Tafsiri, they go to be more going with the sense of the surah is the hadith at mentioned here. قال كان ناس من المؤمنين قبل يقولون لوددنا أن الله عز وجل دلنا على أحب الأعمال إليه فنعمل به فأخبر الله نبيه أن أحب الأعمال إيمان به لا شك فيه وجهاد أهل معصيته الذين خالفوا الإيمان ولم يقروا به فلما نزل الجهاد كره ذلك ناس من المؤمنين وشق عليه. They said, we wish that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed to us what are the dearest or the best action to him subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said subhanahu wa ta'ala, Imanun bihi la shakkun fi. Believing in Allah with no doubt in him subhanahu wa ta'ala. And jihadun, to strive against the people who disobey him and those who reject the faith of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Said when Allah revealed it, some of them, they felt it like, you know, they didn't really accept it within themselves. Kind of, I will not say they hated it, but, you know, kind of they were like not as eager as them when they said it. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, why do you say, you know, think that you do not intend? The hadith that we will take it as a reference in our ayat is this next one, which has been narrated by At-Tirmidhi. قال يقول الرجل قاتلت ولم يقاتل وطعنت ولم يطعن وضربت ولم يضرب وصبرت ولم يصبر. So someone said, you know, I did fight and he didn't. I did this action and in reality he didn't. You know, and so on. So people are like, you know, showing off and not saying the truth. Now, if you take this ayah, I mean this hadith, and we apply them to the ayah that we hear. So, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا لِمَ تَقُولُونَ مَا لَا تَفْعَلُونَ كَبُرَ مَقْتًا عِنْدَ اللَّهِ أَنْ تَقُولُوا مَا لَا تَفْعَلُونَ. Indeed, most hateful it is with Allah that you say that which you do not do. So here there is a wa'id from Allah. Wa'id, threaten of Allah's wrath for those who say things they don't, that they didn't do. إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ الَّذِينَ يُقَاتِلُونَ فِي سَبِيلِي صَفًّا كَأَنَّهُمْ بُنْيَانٌ مَرْصُوصٌ. Verily Allah loves those who fight in His cause in rows, ranks, as if they were a solid structure. Now, this is the first branch of the ayat. So we have the base. Our base is as-saf, ranks. Brother, we need to find the core upon which the branches is going to be, you know, coming out the branches as a surah to understand it as a whole. So if we take the saf is the base. So I say, by base of the surah, I need to start with the saf. And they see in the ayah that Allah mentioned the saf into the rows, fighting in the sake of Allah. Taib, I'll ask you to reflect how important the saf in the life, spiritual life of the Muslim, in the shar'i life. And what's the meaning of the saf? Wada? Just give you a few minutes. طيب organization, before the organization. Remember, you know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talking the base of our creed is La ilaha illallah. So La ilaha illallah upon which is going to build a community that is, subhanallah, in full cohesion together. And this is only can be fulfilled by a community, all of them in sujood, and brother and sisters. So the standing in the prayer as a saf, that is testimony of one heart, all the heart united in one heart, submitted to Allah. So that's the saf. So you see now the base of our tree, which is this subject of our structure, is the saf. The hadith of the Prophet ﷺ, Allah does not look at the crooked saf in the salah. Istawu yarhamukumullah. The angels, they are in rows praying to Allah, even in the heavens. And in the day of judgment, يوم يقول الروح والملائكة صفا لا يتكلمون. So if you try to think of the صف, it's something really has a deep and profound meaning. So if you look at the ayah, so the صف is going to lead to what? I'm going to tell you what to lead. Look, here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talking about Musa. We'll come back. Talking about Isa. We'll come back. And then talk about the nur of Allah. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talking about the believers, about the best of the commerce. And then look at this ayah. وَأُخْرَى تُحِبُّونَهَا نصر من الله وفتح قريب وبشر المؤمنين. And you will obtain another favor that you love, victory from Allah, and an imminent conquest, and give good tidings to the believers. The Nasr and the Fatah, its condition is the base of Saf. You see how we link things together, but making few steps. So the Quran subhanAllah is structured in a way, it's like, as he said subhanahu wa ta'ala, solid structure. So if our base, the base, is the saf, what will be the main subhanAllah a trunk? The trunk is as-sidqu fi an-niyyah, truthfulness in your intention, in your action. Your truthfulness in your intention, in your action, is going to help you to be truthful to Allah, truthful to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and truthful to the message and the mission that you have to fulfill in your life. So the first part, the first branch here, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reproaching, blaming those who have a problem with their intention. They say what they do, they say what they do not do. In this, you broke the saf. You divided the saf. And if you are truly a person who, you know, who love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then if you truly love Allah, then Allah loves those who stand in saf. So the standing in the prayer in the saf, when you align the saf, some people they say, what if the saf it's not, you know, fully aligned? There's a lot of crooked. Said it's not a condition into the validation of the salah. is from mutammimatu salatul jama'ah. What complete salatul jama'ah? So it is like from that beauty of salatul jama'ah. Now we know more. It's that standing who preparing you to stand in a greater occasion. The brother next to you in the salat, that you feel comfortable next to each other. You might be in a very difficult situation that you're already comfortable together. You're not going to run away from each other. You're not going to betray. You're going to be still in saf because you are fully submitted to Allah. So our trunk, if you can say, the core is صِدْقٌ نِيَّةِ فِي الْعَمَلِ. فهير الله سبحانه وتعالى قال إن الله يحب look إن الله يحب يحب Allah loves. So if you want Allah to love you, you have to be among these people who fight in His cause in battle array, or He said in rows. So where are you going to start your rows? In salah. واضح. The second branch, or let's say the first branch that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned after as-safu, and then we have our core, sidqun niyyah, to be sincere and truthful in one's intention. Allah mentioned the story of Musa briefly in one ayah. Look what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said. وَإِذْ قَالَ مُوسَى لِقَوْمِهِ, and behold, Musa said to his people, يَا قَوْمِ لِمَ تُؤْدُونَنِي, my people, why do you harm me? Why do you bother me? Why do you hurt me? While you know certainly that I am the messenger of Allah to you. So, what do you think the kind of hurt that the people of Musa causing to Musa? Almost, because if they don't believe in the message, they're kind of non-believer. But if we'll go with the same subject, yes? Exactly. So it goes with the line of the subject, so they are saying things that they're not doing. And he telling them things, they say, we're going to do it, and they don't do it. And the worst of the thing, when he called them to be in saf, they said, go you and your Lord fight, we are here staying. اذهب أنت وربك فقاتل إن نحن هنا قاعدون. So he said, لِمَ تُؤْذُونَنِي? And you know that as a messenger, so you know that I'm messenger of Allah, which is me, like my saying a revelation from Allah. So if you don't obey me, you don't obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَلَمَّا زَاغُوا أَزَاغَ اللَّهُ قُلُوبَهُمْ وَالْعِيَذُ بِاللَّهِ. So when they turned away, deviated, Allah turned their hearts away. This is explained to you the state of the ummah today. فَلَمَّ زَاغُوا أَزَاغَ اللَّهُ قُلُوبَهُمْ. So if someone take a wrong step and he insists on that wrong step, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala punish that person to let him be in the wrong step. Then came Isa alayhi salam, addressing the same people who hurt Musa. وَإِذْ قَالَ عِيسَى بْنُ مَرْيَمَ يَا بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلَ إِنِّي رَسُولُ اللَّهِ إِلَيْكُمْ مُصَدِّقًا لِمَا بَيْنَ يَدَيَّ مِنَ التَّوْرَاةِ وَمُبَشِّرًا بِرَسُولٍ يَأْتِي مِنْ بَعْدِ اسْمُهُ أَحْمَدُ. Now, Isa alayhi salam, he's giving the glad tidings of the of a messenger of Allah after him. His name is Ahmed. So you see the continuity from Musa, Isa, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The message is the same. the core is the same, if you're not sincere in your intention, then you are of no help to the cause of Allah, and you are actually working against and acting against yourself. You're not hurting the Prophet or hurting Islam. You are indeed causing yourself or the person causing himself or herself to be deviated and be punished by وَالْعِيَذُ بِاللَّهِ being their heart to have perversity as long as they are away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قَالَ فَلَمَّا جَاءَهُمْ بِالْبَيِّنَاتِ قَالُوا هَذَا سِحْرٌ مُبِينٌ. So when the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came to them with the clear evidence, they say this is an evident sorcery or magic. So the rejection of Islam here apply in the same core. So I say, how can we have this branch Musa, Isa, and then we have this part of hypocrite in the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam who were not sincere or like lying into their intention? Because what the people of the book, they said to the Ansar before the coming of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, قال وكانوا من قبله, they open, they say about the coming of a prophet that he gonna be giving them support against the people of mushrikeen of Medina. وكانوا من قبله يستفتحون على الذين كفر فلما جاءهم بالبينات كفروا به. So they say, we have a prophet, you're gonna come, this, we are waiting for a new message. When the new message came, لِمَا تَقُولُونَ مَا لَا تَفْعَلُونَ. So we have that branch of the people of the book, they are, their rejection of the faith is from the same nature that these hypocrites are acting, which is a corrupted intention and absence of truthfulness. Because if they were truthful, they will be the first to accept the deen of Allah. Because subhanallah, look, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us about the people who truly waiting for the message of Allah from many ayat. This is one of them. وَالَّذِينَ آتَيْنَاهُمْ الْكِتَابَ, and those who have given them the book, يَفْرَحُونَ, they rejoice at what has been revealed to you. Why? Because they were waiting. There's an unanswered question. Where is God? Where did he go? There's something unanswered. The answer is in the Quran. يفرحون. So those who were waiting for the Prophet to come, when the Prophet came, but he was from the Arabs, then they denied. فلما جاءهم البينات قالوا هذا سحر مبين. طيب. ومن أظلم ممن افترى على الله الكذب وهو يدعى إلى الإسلام والله لا يهدي القوم الظالمين. So this ayah come to close the two branches that we have, the core and the first branch about the people of the book, and to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help us, instruct us for a divine law. Whoever who harm or hurt a prophet, and hurting prophet by not being truthful to what they say, not to be truthful to Allah or to his message or to his prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, then they're gonna cause perverse زيغ في قلوبهم. And الزيغ والعياذ بالله is to have perversity in one's heart that he cannot or she cannot get rid of it. then قال ومن أظلم ممن افترى على الله الكذبة. Look, الكذبة, الكذبة معرفة. The قال and who is more unjust than one who invents about Allah and truth, invents a lie against Allah. So you see here the relation between this ayah, the absence of truthfulness into the sincerity leads to be an action of dhulm. Because lying is a dhulm. And lying in this case is a forging lying. So it's greater dhulm. When he's called to Islam, so the call to Islam here in a vast meaning. One, he's in Islam and called to Islam. How can be someone in Islam and called to Islam? If someone in Islam and you call him, come to pray, you are calling him to the Islam by calling them to practice what Allah asked them to practice. So when someone, for example, oh, I did, or, you know, I'm busy, things, so subhanAllah, you might enter in this ayah. وَهُوَ يُدْعَى إِلَى الْإِسْلَامِ وَاللَّهُ لَا يَهْدِي الْقَوْمَ الظَّالِمِينَ. Because we have here the munafiqeen and the those ungrateful from the people of the book who heard their own messengers, all are grouped in this ayah. Now, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give you the state of the thing, and as a believer, He assure your heart, because no one can stop the light of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. يريدون ليطفئوا نور الله بأفواههم والله متم نوره ولو كره الكافر. They want to extinguish the light of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with their mouths. But Allah will perfect His light, although the disbeliever disliked it. So the nur of Allah, having a lying intention, being untruthful, this is not stop the light of Allah. Forging lies against the Prophet, against the message of Allah, against Allah, is not gonna be extinguishing the light of Allah. So yuriduna, how many people, all those subhanallah, against the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they wish to stop the light of Allah. One of the scholars, he had given a parable to this. Extinguish is usually when you take, for example, a candle. You light a candle, and there's the fire, and you want to extinguish that, you blow on it. Because قال يريدون ليطفئوا نور الله بأفواههم, right? So you just blow on it to extinguish the fire. So imagine someone doing the same action to the sun. That's the A. Imagine someone turning to the sun, he want to turn. So I said, يُرِيدُونَ لِيُطْفِئُوا نُورَ اللَّهِ بِأَفْوَاهِهِمْ. And the afwayim with their ill talk, with their ill saying, how can the ill saying be compared to the words of Allah? قال والله متم نوره ولو كره الكافرون. Allah is going to complete His light, even despite they are not even in the account. هو الذي أرسل رسوله بالهدى ودين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله ولو كره المشركون. It is He who sent His messenger with guidance and the religion of truth to manifest it over all religion, although those who associate other with Allah disliked it. This ayah, it takes time, so we are discussing, the topic. So, inshallah, we'll have another opportunity to explain it and make the tafsir of it. However, these two ayat, come to close, let's say, the two branches that we have. So the first branch we have those who speak or say things that they do not do. They are like them, you know, who's like them is the people of Musa. And also how Isa alayhi salam. So you see the ayah connected here. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, despite the fact of your insincerity, your lying, your untruthfulness or absence of truthfulness, Allah is going to continue His nur. So this ayah come to be kind of a line between the previous ayat and the ayat after it. So how can it be a line? So here is security and assurance for the believer. And subhanallah, and make like subhanallah the disbeliever or the ungrateful to die with their wrath and their anger in their heart. Do whatever you do. Fake whatever you fake. Plot whatever you plot. Allah is going to finish His nur. The believer on one side, they're sometimes concerned. When they hear a hurtful saying, it hurt them. You know, it really make them sad. So this ayah come to assure them, say, don't even think about it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to complete His nur. So do your part, be patient and act. And that's why it comes after the ayah, who help the believer to be active, to be focused, to be in a state of khushu' for what they have to do. Do not look around you who are talking ill about you. Just focus on what you have to do. And look, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا What you need to do? هَلْ أَدُلُّكُمْ عَلَى تِجَارَةٍ تُنْجِيكُمْ مِنْ عَذَابٍ أَلِيمٍ Or you believe, should I guide you to a commerce that will save you from a painful torment? What is this? تؤمنون بالله ورسوله وتجاهدون في سبيل الله بأموالكم وأنفسكم ذلكم خير لكم إن كنتم تعلمون. So this the path to what? To الصف. So this is a call to the whole believer. يا أيها الذين آمنوا. So the oath between Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the believer is what? The iman. So when he called them here, oh you who believe, you cannot do such a thing because this is gonna cast the wrath of Allah on Allah on you. How Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give you the gift of the iman? And you become and you are untruthful or like lying into your intention, not sincere into your intention. So back, I will remind you with the oath that I have between me and you, which is the iman. And Allah is the most merciful. I'm guiding you to the best of the commerce. A commerce that never perishes. And a commerce that is going to give you the greatest of the profit, which is to be saved from the doom of the hellfire. وَالْعِيَذُ بِاللَّهِ تُؤْمِنُونَ بِاللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ وَتُجَاهِدُونَ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ بِأَمْوَالِكُمْ وَأَنفُسِكُمْ ذَلِكُمْ خَيْرٌ لَكُمْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تَعْلَمُونَ And look the benefit of it. يَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ ذُنُوبَكُمْ Forgive your sins. وَيُدْخِلْكُمْ And admit you in gardens that beneath with flows, you know, the rivers, ومساكن dwelling, pleasant and pure dwelling, في جنات عدن, in a garden of eternity. ذلك الفوز العظيم. That is the supreme achievement and the great attainment. Now, look how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala finished this ayah. That is the supreme achievement, the great attainment, and the great success. All of it the فوز العظيم. طيب. According to this surah, what is the path to the great success? According to this surah. The surah is Madani. We are in Medina now. The path to al-fawz al-azim is al-saf. Because to Allah give you this, He said, believe in Allah and His Messenger. تؤمنون بالله ورسوله. It requires that part to be sincere into your intention. Sincere in your intention give you that willpower to be striving in the sake of Allah with all what you have. And if you are at this level, you will be in a solid structure with your brother and sister in facing or in fulfilling the mission. That is the greater for you if you do know. And if you do such a thing, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala giving you what He's going to give you. If there's anything that Allah mentioned here match with any success in this dunya, get all the PhD of the whole world, is going to match with this? Or all the money of the world is going to match with this? So this is the definition of the meaning of the greatest achievement. So really, if everyone looking to have success, that's the path of the success. Then قال وأخرى تحبون نصر من الله وفتح قريب وبشر المؤمنين. We mentioned this. So you see the Nasr. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is from Allah. The help, the victory, the triumph is from Allah. And the conquest is from Allah. This is the one who subhanAllah gave you the glad tidings. The glad tidings comes after an achievement. Right? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you after you pray. And after you complete your prayer. If someone during the prayer, he lost or she lost her wudu, they have to stop the prayer, right? So they didn't finish that action of the prayer. So the action need to be completed for the glad tidings to come. And when the action is completed in the community, in the ummah, when every one of us will pray Qiyamul Layl on his own, when we come in rows, united in one heart, how can we do that? What is the first action that we need to be aware of to help us, you know, have that willpower that drive us toward this? Allah is answering you here. يا أيها الذين آمنوا كونوا أنصار الله. Oh, you who believe, be you helper of Allah, supporter of Allah's cause. As when Isa ibn Maryam said to his disciple, who are my supporters to Allah, for Allah, the disciple that said, we are supporter of Allah. He said, قال, said to his, we are, who are, be my helper to the work of Allah. كونوا أنصار الله. فآمن الطائفة من بني إسرائيل كفر الطائفة فأيدنا الذين آمنوا على أدوهم فأصبحوا ظاهرين. قال we gave power to those who believed against their enemies and they became the ones that prevailed. So this is the conclusion of the surah. So we have our base, as-saf. The core of it is the sincerity in the intention. The branch to see the lie, what it leads to, the corrupt intention. And then the other branch, the assurance that the light of Allah is going to be continued, which is comes to really demoralize in a way the ungrateful and boost the moral of the believers. And then the path to that is the true iman, sincerity, and jihad, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned it, and how to start it to come all together for everyone to be in his own, in his mind, in his heart, that he's the helper of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Helper in the sake. Ansarullah. So when you be from the Ansarullah, it's going to be kind of the guide in your life. The guide wherever you are. You being mindful. There is something, subhanAllah, in your mind to help you guide your action toward the mission of being Ansarullah. And that what will bring the Ummah together to be, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, as a solid structure, staying or like standing in rows for the sake of Allah. Mentioning the fight here is very obvious because the most difficult time to find courage and to be determined, you know, to fulfill really, or like the test of the truthfulness, is in such difficult situation. So this is, you know, in brief, the topic, the analysis, or the topic analysis that we have done for Surah As-Saff. So far we have three surahs, two Mekki and one, this one Madani. And you see the Madani, it has different flair, different, you know, ambience than the Mekki. The Mekki is addressing to the nafs, to the soul. Ya ayyatu an-nafs al-mutma'inna la aqsimu bin-nafs al-lawwama 'alimat nafsun ma ahdarat. In the Madani is the community. Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu. So you see the difference. So it's more the Mekki is about the purification, about strengthening the aqidah, about the vision of life, about, you know, the core of the way of thinking. In Medina is about how to establish the structure of the deen of Allah in the society and be really, you know, those who implement the deen of Allah. Not only in the society, restricted society, but at large, and it incorporates the whole universe, because that the mission that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave to the children of Adam. Taib, any question? Look like from what perspective? From what? How do they establish these? I mean, when we say just open a masjid is something big, it's not just open the masjid. Something big. I mean, to open a place to pray. When everybody is, his heart is with Allah, is something very big. So the masjid is, becomes the place of unity, the place of meeting, the place of consultation. It becomes real, you know, the whole government, if you can say, is really managed in the masjid. Managed in the place where everyone is humble, managed in the place where everyone is submitted to Allah. At the high capacity to listen, to understand, to argue in the best way, and that's the power of the masjid. It's good, isn't it? We lost that. Yeah. Any question? Tay. Inshallah ta'ala, I don't know, do you want to, let's go to the tafsir. Start with Surah Al-Fatiha. So this is Tafsir Ibn Kathir. Maybe you don't need this. We have this tafsir, right? Ibn Kathir. You received it?
Yes.
We said in our methodology, let's go back to just remind you. Where can I find it? So this is what we're going to follow. Methodology. So our purpose, we opting for this study, is to understand the intent of the ayah of the Quran in order to guide us in our daily life, building our project and understanding, clarifying the element of success in the reality and the world, the reality of the world we live in. In order to honor this objective, we need the following steps. Define the vision with which we need to approach the ayat. That is defined, because our vision is the authentic sound aqidah and the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Knowing the characteristic of the Quran is the core of all the fundamental. It is the measure of all systems and it is the reference to everything. We cannot bring any system to have it to criticize or as a tool, to analyze the Quran with. The Quran is the tool to analyze others. And the guidance is in the Quran, not in anything else. Compile the ma'thur. So those are principles that we agreed upon. Compile the ma'thur the ma'thur is transmitted tafsir from the Salaf, reason of revelation. We study it as we've been, meaning an indication of words in the Quran, notes on reason of revelation, and so on. So either. Then reflection with the goal to gain an understanding which help build a correction guidance plan for the life we lived in the present life. So we want this fourth objective, it's really embedded in the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, as Aisha used to describe him, he was a Quran walking sallallahu alaihi wasallam, right? That's the fourth objective in our tafsir. How can we understand it in a way to implement it in our life according to the reality that we live in? So we go back to the tafsir of Ibn Kathir, Surah Al-Fatiha. What we're going to say first about Surah Al-Fatiha, what we need to know, where the surah is revealed, that's the first thing. Where the surah is revealed. For example, this surah is Makki. This surah is Makki. Called Al-Fatiha, the surah is Makki. And its ayat is 7 ayat. The surah is Makki. So it's revealed in Mecca. Some of the scholars they say it revealed many times, twice, one time in Mecca and one time in Medina. When we say in Mecca, so we are setting an environment and ambience in our mind about this surah. Right? So what is this ambience? This ambience is an ambience of building aqidah, of knowing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And our relation with Allah define the way of our life. Really, our relation with Allah, which define the way of our life. This surah is called Al-Fatiha. So, Mecca, 7 ayat. However, if you read, we don't want to go through the difference of opinion concerning the number of the ayat Surah Al-Fatiha. Is Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim ayah from Surah Al-Fatiha or it's not? This is, there's two school of thought. They're saying it's not an ayah. It's just to open the surah. And other, they say it is an ayah. Those who say it is an ayah, they have it in the Quran, as you see it here, in this page. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, ayah 1. I can show you, for example, Quran with the, for example, with other qira'ah. Just for you to see the difference. There's a website. It's good for you to know. خلون سورة الفاتحة. سورة الفاتحة. Look. The first A is الحمد لله رب العالمين. See? Okay. The first A it's not. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. However, there are still seven A's. So the sixth A is صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم. When the first ayah is Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, the seventh ayah is Sirat al-Ladina an'amta alayhim ghayri al-maghdubi alayhim wala al-dallin. So just to show you the difference of opinion about, but we're not going to discuss it. Okay. However, why we only seven? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that we have given you seven repeated recited ayahs, سَبْعَ الْمَثَانِ وَالْقُرْآنَ الْعَظِيمِ. And the Ahlul Tafsir, they said the سَبْعَ الْمَثَانِ are the ayah, Surah Al-Fatiha. I will read here from the Tafsir of Ibn Kathir and some of our Tafsir, so to in this first step, which is collecting the ma'thur, referring to the ma'thur. قال يقول أبو بكر ابن أبي داود يعني حيث يقرأ في الصلاة قال واكتفيت بحفظ المسلمين لها عن كتابتها وقد قيل إن الفاتحة أول شيء أنزل من القرآن كما ورد في حديث رواه البيهقي. It's been narrated that the Fatiha is the first thing that been revealed in the Quran, as Al-Imam Al-Bayhaqi mentioned. قال أحد أقوال ثلاثة وقيل يا أيها المدثر, and some of other scholars they say يا أيها المدثر. Beside of course إقرأ, that we know that it was the first thing that is been mentioned or revealed from the Quran. Now, one of the etiquette when reciting, you know, doing the tafsir, to see the hadith that has been narrated or mentioning the surah. So here, يذكر قال what we call فضائل سورة الفاتحة. What are the benefit or the bounties that been mentioned, you know, concerning سورة الفاتحة. قال الإمام أحمد. I don't know if you, so you have the tafsir here when I. نعم. قال الإمام, you'll find it here إن شاء الله. قال الإمام أحمد ابن حنبل رحمه الله تعالى في مسنده the hadith without going through the chain of narration. كنت أصلي, هذا عن أبي سعيد ابن المعلى. قال كنت أصلي فدعاني رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم فلم أجبه حتى صليت فأتيته فقال ما منعك أن تأتيني. In this hadith, عاصم ابن أبي سعيد ابن المعلى, he said I was praying, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم called him, he said I finished my prayer and then I went to the Prophet, told him why you didn't come when I asked you and I called you, what held you back. قال قلت يا رسول الله إني كنت أصلي. I said يا رسول الله I was praying. قال ألم يقل الله تعالى يا أيها الذين آمنوا استجيبوا لله وللرسول إذا دعاكم إلى ما يحييكم. Did not Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said answer the call of Allah and His Messenger with a call to which, to which, to that which give you life. I mean, this is not anybody calling you. It's the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. قال ثم قال لأعلمنك أعظم سورة في القرآن قبل أن تخرج من المسجد. Said, I will teach you the best surah in the Quran before you leave the masjid. قال فأخذ بيدي فلما أراد أن يخرج من المسجد قلت يا رسول الله إنك قلت لأعلمنك أعظم سورة في القرآن. So he held his hand and he was leaving the masjid. He said, Ya Rasulullah, you told me before we leave the masjid, you're going to teach me the best of the best surah in the, or the greatest surah in the Quran. قال نعم. He said, نعم. الحمد لله رب العالمين. هي السبع المثاني والقرآن العظيم الذي أوتيته. It is the seven مثاني and the Quran العظيم that I have been provided or been revealed to me. So that's the, so أعظم سورة في القرآن. أعظم سورة في القرآن. I'm gonna put them as the keys. I want you to take note. You know, question mark. أعظم سورة في القرآن. To put a question mark. Not to question, you know, its greatness. No. To understand the wisdom why is great. I tell you, you know, the greatest thing in our life is water. Said, okay. You go every store, you find like stock water. You don't. But when someone comes in a difficulty in a place where he's in a remote place and there's, you know, he does not have anyone to help him, he's broke down or something, his car cannot move, and he's thirsty, he understands that water is going to give him life. So he understands how much the water in his life is great. And that's, subhanAllah, something very important. You know, that's why when we study the tafsir, you're going to see or you'll have a lot of thoughts that bring you to help you, you know, in many aspects in your life, even though they're not associated with the ayat. How many think great in your life, you don't even pay attention to them? How many things? Then it comes that the ability to love is being granted, and this is how subhanAllah one is deviated, to the things that they're not great in your life. Imagine someone who said, I love water. Say, you know, the relation with, because we understand the love is something like emotional. We don't understand it from a need perspective. You know, I need water. I love water. I need my parents. You know, I need in a way like, you know, as a family. I love my parents. So on. The same when it comes to the greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, just on the side. So put a question mark, أعظم, you're going to see the secret in Surah Al-Fatiha is going to tell you, subhanAllah, you know, now we understand why the Prophet ﷺ said the greatest surah in the Quran. Let's put these keys to go back to them. And you see, this is what the ma'thur help to direct our understanding of the surah. طيب. وهكذا روى البخاري عن مسدد وعلي ابن المديني كلاهما عن يحيى بن سعيد القطان. The same Bukhari, الإمام بخاري, he mentioned this hadith. Another hadith. وقد وقع في الموطأ للإمام مالك بن أنس رحمة الله عليه ما ينبغي التنبيه عليه فإنه رواه مالك عن العلاء. Now Ibn Kathir, he's talking here about the path of the hadith that he mentioned. قال وعن عبد الرحمن بن يعقوب الحرقي أن أبا سعيد مولى عامر بن كريز أخبرهم أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم نادى أبي بن كعب وهو يصلي في المسجد فلما فرغ من صلاته لحقه قال فوضع النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يده على يدي وهو يريد أن يخرج من باب المسجد ثم قال sallallahu aleyhi ve sellem inni la arju alla takhruja min babil masjid hatta ta'lama suratan ma unzila fit tawrati wala fil injili wala fil qur'ani mithluha. He held the hand of Ubay ibn Ka'b. So this is another hadith to see in many occasions how the Prophet ﷺ teaching the companion the greatness of Surah Al-Fatiha. Now, see the way of the teaching of the Prophet ﷺ. And this is, subhanAllah, it helps us to learn, you know, how to help educate others, especially the young ones. So in this same hadith, the Prophet held, you know, the hand of the companion. What the meaning of it? That subhanAllah, that close to them, you know, to open their heart, soften their heart. And then he delayed the teaching till they leave the masjid. Why that? To have them, subhanAllah, that that enthusiasm, that craving for the knowledge. If you come to say to someone, he said, Assalamu alaikum, you know, the best surah is Surah Al-Fatiha. Say, Jazakum Allah khair. But you say, you know what is the greatest surah in the Quran? I will let you know before you leave the masjid. That time to think about it, to reflect, it trays your craving to know it. When you know it, is not, you're not gonna forget it. So in this hadith, he said to Ubay, radiallahu ta'ala an, qala, when he finished the prayer and he was leaving, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam went after Ubay and he held his hand before he left the masjid and he said, إِنِّي لَأَرْجُ, I would like that before you leave the masjid, you know, till you know. I don't want you to leave the masjid till you know a surah that nothing like it was revealed in the Tawrat or in the Injil or in the Quran. Which in this hadith we understand that the Fatiha is not part of the Quran. Fatiha and the Quran. قال أوتيت السبع المثاني والقرآن العظيم. واضح. قال أبي رضي الله عنه فجعلت أبطئ في المشي رجاء ذلك. Then he started to slow down his pace, waiting for the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم to tell him. He slowed down his pace, waiting for the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. To tell him, ثم قلت يا رسول الله ما السورة التي وعدتني. What is the surah that you promised me to tell me? See the craving for knowledge and how he used to teach them صلى الله عليه وسلم. قال كيف تقرأ إذا افتتحت الصلاة. How do you recite when you start the صلاة. قال فقرأت عليه. So Ubay, he read on the Prophet الحمد لله رب العالمين till I get to the end. قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم هي هذه السورة وهي السبع المثان والقرآن والقرآن العظيم. And it is the seven repeated ayah. واضح. So the our story with Surah Al-Fatiha is getting big now. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم twice in this hadith he's mentioning to the to Ubay and to the other Sahabi about the greatest surah in the Quran. Now also we know that is not part of the Quran, like we have Sab'al Mathani and the Quran. طيب, you can just, we have it here, this is on thing, but I'm reading on the original text, which is for me more Al-Hujurat Madani. الدهر هل أتى على الإنسان حين من الدهر لم يكن شيئا مذكورا. الحجر مكية مكي. It has the element and the specific of the Makki surah. Because it has the story of the Prophet. It has the story of Ibrahim and Lut. And the story of Adam. And the story of the contemplation and the creation. And the story of the Prophet facing the Mushrikeen. فاصدع بما تؤمر وأعرض عن الجاهل. That's Makki. Now, of course, if you have studied before Ibn Kathir as a reference to take, because there's a Tabari, there's a, I mean, a Tabari is the first of the most structured tafsir ever written, and the first one. You have Al-Qurtubi, you have Al-Baydawi, you have those all from the eminent tafsir of the Salaf. Qala, so if you have studied, you'll see that Ibn Kathir, he will repeat the same hadith many times from different paths. And that's, you know, from the trust and from the amana of the knowledge. When Al-Imam al-Tabari in his tariq was writing many of a hadith and many of the stories that they are very weak. When he was asked, rahimahullah, about such a thing, he said, from amanat al-ilm is to put what is being has transmitted. That's one thing. Second, sometimes the environment, the political environment, the ambience of the society, if you want to say things like straightforward, you might be hurt and not be able even to finish your book. Because there's people opposing some of your ideas. So the scholar of the hadith, they don't tell you this hadith is da'if at that time. They give you the chain of narration for you to know that it's da'if. So when they give you the chain of narration, they told you everything. So Ibn Kathir, he'll give you the different path of the hadith. As a scholar also of hadith, eminent scholar of hadith, rahimahullah ta'ala. In the tafsir, قال هي فاتحة الكتاب وبها تفتح يستفتح بها القراءة في الصلوات. So it's with which we start the قراءة in the salawat. And also is called أم الكتاب. Also is called أم الكتاب عند الجمهور among the majority of the scholars. And this hadith ذكره أنس والحسن ابن سيرين. قال الحسن وابن سيرين إنما ذلك اللوح المحفوظ. According to الحسن, he said أم الكتاب is اللوح المحفوظ, is the saved tablet. However, the majority of the scholar, they say it is أم الكتاب as in الصحيح عند الترمذي عن أبي هريرة that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, قال الحمد لله رب العالمين أم القرآن وأم الكتاب. الحمد لله رب العالمين أم القرآن, the mother of the Quran, and it is the mother of the book, and the book here is the Quran. والسبع المثاني والقرآن العظيم, and it is السبع المثاني. ويقال لها الحمد, and also his name الحمد. Say recite الحمد, الحمد. ويقال لها الصلاة, لقوله صلى الله عليه وسلم عن ربه قسمت الصلاة بيني وبين عبدي نصفين. The hadith, the salat being divided between me and my servant in two halves. And the salat is al-fatiha. This is beautiful hadith. فَإِذَا قَالَ الْعَبْدُ الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ قَالَ اللَّهُ حَمَدَنِي عَبْدِي. When the servant say Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, glory and hamd to Allah, the God of the world, قال الله حمدني عبدي. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say, my servant thanked me or praised me. ويقال حمدني عبدي, and the hadith, as you know, that's the hadith of, and he didn't mention the whole hadith, but when I call Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen Hamadani Abdi, Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim Majadani Abdi, and then Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim Maliki Yawmiddin, the same thing, and then يقول إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين, he said this between me and هذا بيني وبين عبدي. And we're going to explain this hadith because it's the heart of the explanation of Surah Al-Fatiha. And then اهدنا الصراط المستقيم, to the end, he said, my servant has asked it, and to my servant what he has asked it. So Allah grant him what he has asked. But the key is in إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين, because this hadith, we're going to use it inshallah in our tafsir. قال فسميت الفاتحة صلاة لأنها شرط فيها. And call it also salat because it's a condition in the prayer. For those scholars who said it's a condition, without it, the salat is not completed, or actually is not valid. Is not completed according to the Hanafi school, and is not completed, and it's not valid according to the Jumhur. ويقال لها الشفاء, and also called the healer. لما رواه الدرمي عن أبي سعيد مرفوعا حديث فاتحة الكتاب شفاء من كل سم. The hadith that الدرمي in a hadith mentioned that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, the opening of the book, or the opening which is الفاتحة, شفاء من كل سم. It cure from any poison. ويقال لها الرقية, also called الرقية. Al-Ruqya, which is also the action of healing, or the action to heal. لحديث أبي سعيد في الصحيح حين رقى بها الرجل السليم فقال له رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم وما يدريك أنها رقية. The hadith of the companion, they were traveling and they asked, you know, people for some food. They refused, and then they came to them afterward when they see them camping, begging them to help them heal their, you know, chief or leader who been bit by a snake. So one of the companions said, let's go. None of them was a physician or anything. قال فقرأ عليه الفاتحة. He read الفاتحة. But before that he said, if we'll do what you give us. So they had, you know, an agreement on some few goats. فَقَرَأَ عَلَيْهِ الْفَاتِحَةِ. He read the Fatiha, and the person, subhanAllah, Allah healed that person. So when they got the goats, everyone was happy. They said, let's eat from it. So he said, he doubted. He said, no, you should not touch it. I don't know if this is halal or not. Let's go back to the Prophet ﷺ. So when they came back and they told him the story, he said, قَالَ وَمَا يُدْرِيكَ أَنَّهَا رُقِيَ. How did you know that he's a ruqya that can heal? And then he approved what they have done. وَرَوَى الشَّعْبِيُّ عَنْ إِبْنِ عَبَّاسٍ أَنَّهُ سَمَّاهَا أَسَاسُ الْقُرْآنِ. الشَّعْبِي mentioned that Ibn Abbas, you know, in a hadith, he said, أساس القرآن, the basis of the Qur'an, or the foundation of the Qur'an. وأساسها بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. وسماها سفيان بن عيينة بالواقية, the protector. This is الفاتحة. وسماها يحيى بن كثير الكافية. الكافية is sufficient. It will suffice you. كما جاء في بعض الأحاديث المرسلة حديث أم القرآن عوض من غيرها إلى آخره.
وقال أبو هريرة ويقال نزلت مرتين.
This is what I have mentioned. And it's also, it has been said that it was narrated, revealed twice. One time in Mecca and the second time in Medina. And this is in Ulum al-Quran, some of the surah that has been revealed more than one time to show their greatness. Like Surah also narrated that Surah Al-Ikhlas was revealed more than one time.
وَالْأَوَّلُ أَشْبَهُ. And for the evidence of the first that is revealed in Mecca, we have the ayah in Surah Al-Hijr, ayah 87. وهي سبع آيات بخلاف. We have the difference of opinion that I have showed you on the Mus'haf.
According to the Maliki school, the Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim is not an ayah. The rest of the scholars, they said it is an ayah. However, the difference is in the having the Bismillah to be an ayah, then it will give different vision in the tafsir than if you take off Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim not being an ayah. Different, subhanAllah. Yeah. As he's saying here, قال, it has seven ayah according to the majority of the reciters, Al-Kufa, a group of the companion, the Tabi'een, and number of the scholars. So seven ayah, there's no is consensus in it. However, the beginning of it, we'll mention it again soon. Okay. The number of the words and the letters in Al-Fatiha. The scholars say the Al-Fatiha consists of 25 words and that it contains 113 letters. In the beginning of the book of Tafsir in the Sahih Al-Bukhari, it's called Ummul Kitab because the Quran started with it and because the prayer is started by reciting it. It was also said that it is called Ummul Kitab because it contains the meaning of the entire Quran. Ibn Jarir said the Arab call every comprehensive matter that contains several specific area an and that's actually what I was going to verify when I said put the question mark how the greatest because it contained the whole Quran. The whole Quran is in Surah Al-Fatiha. We'll explain it inshallah. You can stop as jawaz al-waqf. It's permissible to stop, but that's not the end of this ayah. If you ayah by ayah, in hafiz you have to stop, or in as. You have to keep going. But if you stop jawaz, for hafiz jawaz, I mean, because you can stop. You stop because of the meaning, not because of this. But if someone reciting, an official recitation to follow the qira'ah as it should be, they don't stop. اهدنا الصراط الصراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. الصراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. See any other hadith that we need to mention? We read the whole hadith. That the قسمت الصلاة بيني وبين عبدي نصفين. The salat has been divided between me and my servant to two halves. I don't know if I'm sure that it is somewhere here.
This is the full. Here he is the hadith. قسمت الصلاة بيني وبين عبدي إلى نصفين. Don't know why this didn't want to close it and have it back.
طيب خير ان شاء الله. طيب we'll stop here ان شاء الله and we'll meet you at 7:40. You take the break after ان شاء الله. إن شاء الله after the break صلاة and break.
بعدين إن شاء الله. الله يحفظكم وزيد ما خلصت شيء ذا. بعدين أي حتى ما يبدأ. الله يخليك.